Okay, guys, I am here with Luis Silva, and he is from Preferred Lending, our in-house lender here at Berkshire Hathaway. We're doing a first-time home buyer seminar coming up pretty soon, and just wanted to give you a little bit of information about it. It's going to be on Tuesday, June 20th at 6:30 p.m. at our Bel Air office. All that information will be in the notes. Tell me why it's important for people to get pre-qualified for a loan before they begin their home search.
More than anything, it gives them peace of mind of knowing where they are currently or where they can be and what they qualify for. Especially for an agent, when you're house hunting for someone, it's always great to know what is it that they qualify for, what payment is comfortable for them, and what price range they should be in.
Okay. And during our first-time home buyer seminar, will you be helping people if they want to know what they're qualified for? Can you do that on the spot?
We really could do it on the spot. Ultimately, an ideal thing would be a complete application so we get credit and all that, but having sometimes simple conversations about where their credit might be and what debt load is, what income is, that typically gives them a general idea of where they're going to land.
Okay. And for people who know, I don't have great credit. You know, my credit is not that great. I am destined to rent forever. What would you say to those people?
I can't tell you how many times I've had someone come back and say, hey, Luis, thank you so much for that information. I did what you told me to do. I took care of this. I took care of that. I think I'm ready. And next thing you know, we're writing a contract. To me, honestly, those are by far the best experiences that I have typically.
So you also believe people are not destined to rent?
No, they're not. I mean, it really just takes will and it does take some discipline. It does take some discipline. And I think with the right tools and a little bit of advice, they could get past some of their own fears and start telling themselves they can own a home.
Okay. And what piece of advice would you give to everyone out there who's saying, I don't know if I'm willing to put the work in? What piece of advice in your experience in the lending business, what would you say to those people?
You know, one of my favorite sayings that I've been able to take on recently, and I use it in my own personal life, and it's, how do you eat an elephant?
One bite at a time.
Right? One bite at a time. And sometimes what it is that it could seem overwhelming, right? The perspective is different for everyone. For some people, it's like, oh, that's it? Great, I'll take care of that. For other people, it's like, oh my God, that just sounds like too much, and how do I even start that process? And it's just step by step, and we could help walk them through that.
And we're going to help walk them through that at this home buyer seminar, right?
That's right.
All right.
All right.
Okay, I am here with Mark Van Loo, and Mark has a lot of experience with first-time home buyer situations and homes in general. Mark, tell us a little bit about your experience in this area.
Well, I spent 22 years with Habitat for Humanity. Many people will recognize that name, a world-known nonprofit who helps first-time home buyers and low-income home buyers achieve home ownership. So I gained a lot of experience over that time helping to, you know, help thousands and thousands of first-time home buyers buy that first home and achieve their dream of home ownership. So that's where the bulk of my experience comes from, on first-time home buyers and lower income buyers, and helping them tap into the various programs that are out there, whether through private nonprofits or city, state, county, federal resources, to be able to get over that hump and get that first home.
And would you say, I feel like there are a lot of people out there who feel that they are destined to rent for the rest of their lives for one reason or another. Would you say that it's fair for me to say to those people, you absolutely do not have to rent for the rest of your life? There are ways we can help you get your first home.
Absolutely. No matter what your situation, there are ways to get it done. You may be ready now and not even know it with certain by tapping into certain resources. If you're not ready now, we know people who can help you get ready. And that may take as little as a few weeks. It could take a few years. But this is a goal well worth pursuing. And everybody can get there, I promise you. It may seem like it's an impossible dream, but you can get there. We have the resources to help you get there, and we want to do that. We want to help you achieve that dream of home ownership, because that is what breaks that cycle of the inability to build wealth and to pass wealth on to your kids. When you buy that home and that home appreciates in value and you pay down the mortgage, you build equity or value in that home. And to pass wealth on to your kids. When you buy that home and that home appreciates in value and you pay down the mortgage, you build equity or value in that home. And one day you can tap into that for any number of reasons, whether to help your kids with their education costs, whether to fund your retirement, or whether to pass that wealth on to your kids so that they have a leg up in life.
And would you say the people out there who say, well, my parents never owned a home, we always rented, it's not a big deal to rent. Well, it maybe isn't a big deal to rent, but there was an article just this morning on Fox 13 that said you have to make $84,000 a year to be able to afford to pay your rent. That's a lot of money, and I don't know a lot of people who make that kind of money out in the regular world. This is a tourism, hospitality area. I don't know people who make that kind of money. So this is just another reason that people need to know how they can buy their first home. And you have the connections. Lewis, that we spoke to earlier today, we have the connections to get people there.
Right. Absolutely. Yeah, it's, you know, there are times in everybody's life where renting can make sense. But ultimately, I believe in home ownership. Again, for the reasons I've already stated, that ability to build wealth, that stability. You know, once you buy that home, whatever that house payment is, it's not going to go up. You know, nobody's going to knock on your door one day and say, sorry to tell you this, but, you know, your rent's going up X amount. Now, that's assuming you have a fixed rate mortgage, which is what most people do these days. If you have a variable rate mortgage, then yes, your payment could go up. But we'll teach you all that. We'll talk about that. We'll make sure you understand how all that works so that you get into the right product. And we can definitely get you there. I can't tell you how many people I have worked with who said in the beginning, I don't think this is ever going to work. I've tried before. I've not been able to do it. And in the end, they were oftentimes the first people in their family for perhaps generations to own a home. And they were so proud. So let us help you get there.
Absolutely. And they should be proud. This is a big deal. And we definitely have the resources to get you there. So Mark, thank you very much. I'm looking forward to a great seminar. And if you know someone who's looking to buy their first home or who thinks maybe they just don't want to rent forever, come to the seminar Tuesday, June 20th, 6:30 p.m. It's at 321 North Indian Rocks Road, Suite A. Text 317-373-3741 to RSVP, and we'll see you there.
Bye.